Hello everyone, today this video is my first video to be posted in YouTube. I've been wanting to do this kind of video for the longest time, but I'm just not feeling up to it until today when I'm trying to get to air out my bags and I realize that I have so many bags. So while I'm trying to declutter my closet, I thought maybe I'll just give a bag collection, you know. And right now I'm giving a bird eye view of my bed. This is a queen size bed with all my handbags. So right now I have altogether 28 bags. So okay, I think yeah, we have a lot to go through, so I think we should start now. Without further ado, so let me just let the bird just fly down a little bit. Okay, there's no particular order of how I'm going to film this. So yeah, I'm just going to reach out for the bag nearest to me. Okay, right here. I got this is from Gucci. Alright, oh, this is flashing back. Alright, this, I'm not sure what this is called. This is a large size, black color. I think this is the Gucci Sami Web Hobo bag. It's a very large and roomy bag. Yep, like so. Very slouchy. Okay. And has a very comfortable handle strap here. A shoulder strap. Alright. Next. This is a Chanel. I think this color is a camel with silver hardware. Very nice bag, and this is in the medium size. Yep, you must be wondering how come I have this red color. This is actually a red color rubber band. I just started to do this like 2 days ago, trying to keep my bags in shape. I'm still trying to find out the best way of storing my bags, so please don't do the same, because it's just the third day that I'm doing this and I'm not sure what this will do to my bags. Probably a bad idea, but I'll probably report again how this do, or maybe I'll just have to change the color of my rubber band in case the rubber band is going to melt and leave a red marks on the side of the bags, or we're still here. I just gotta come back and check again. And right beside this is also a Chanel. This is in mini, size mini, and silver hardware with black pattern. This is a very, very nice, dressy, casual, former, just a really pretty bag. Okay, oops, I got something falling here. Okay. Not all of my bags are high-end luxury. I still have some low and mid-range. And this is from Kate Kiston with a dark navy color, white polka dots all around it. So this is I don't really carry this much, but once in a while I do find it very youthful and sweet when I have to be. Okay, can you just stand? All right, going next. This is my LV Louis Vuitton. I think this is a pochette accessoire. Yep, in gold hardware, and then there's a leather strap with this thing here, a clasp. I just leave it out because I'm trying to air this thing. This is a very, very useful handbag to have. So if I'm running out and trying to grab something small, I'll gravitate towards this. And I can see that the leather is already splitted here. So probably I'm gonna get some leather glue or go back to Louis Vuitton and see what they can help with the repair here. It's nothing major, I can still live with it. Next, this is the Rebecca Minkoff in black. And then this is the version, this is not the MAC version, this is the zipper version. So there's three zipper here, on top there's the main zipper. And this comes with a black change, it's not black, a golden change crossbody. I use these mainly when I go overseas because this brand doesn't shout and it's not in your face, and it's very, very useful in terms of functionality because it got zips and you can put your passport in outside for outside in this zipper pocket for easy access. Yep. Okay, next. This is the first Hermes. This is the Picotine or the Picotine 18 in, I'm not sure of the leather. I would think that this is a Negonda or a Clermont. I'm not so sure. And this is in the silver hardware. Okay, next. This is one of my Longchamp. I do not have a lot of Longchamp, but this is the one I have. And it's also one of the colored bags I have. This is a very bright red, but in real life, it doesn't look that red on the video here. But nevertheless, this, whenever I carry this, I can feel that the color is very vibrant. It always makes me very happy. So yeah, it's very functional and easy to carry too. And this is the version, not the nylon version. This is the leather version. Yep, very nice and spacious, easy to carry. Yes. Next, this is the Louis Vuitton Speedy 25. In Damier Ibin. This is one of my favorite bags. It's fast free, it's easy to use, and it's all season bag. When it rains, this is the first bag that comes to my mind, and it fits a tons, as you can see here. I'm just annoyed at the opening, seriously, this opening. Although my hand is the tiniest in the world, but this thing is still small. Anyway, it's still a very great bag. I highly recommend this. Next, we came to the most expensive bag of my collection. Yep. This is an Hermes Cali. This is a Cali 28 in Rouge Ash. Not sure what comes first. In gold hardware. And this is the box leather. I really like the box leather. It gives a very luxurious feel to the overall aesthetic of the bag. And I do not think that it's so hard to maintain. In fact, when I read up the Purse Forum, there have been suggestions to use the Black Rock to maintain this leather, and when I bought Black Rod to clean up and condition the leather, I do feel that the Black Rod is doing this leather a great service, making it back totally new after it. So I highly recommend box leather. It does scratch, but nothing too, unless you were to scratch it with your screwdriver. I think it's quite manageable, so long you are a moderately careful person, and any scratches can basically be buffed out by your fingers or by black rod, so no worries for me. This is the one with the double hook, so it's not as old. I can't remember how old is this. Maybe 10 years old. Oh, it's a F stamp. Yeah, F for Finland. Okay, next. This is the black collar YSL Yves Saint Laurent. I think this is called the Cabas. I'm not sure this is the mini or the small size. I think this is the small. It's not super tiny. Yeah, it looks almost the same size as my Kelly. Okay, this is in the gold hardware. I bought this because I think that the design is very, very classy and nice. And it does hold a lot too. It comes with a long strap. So yeah. So anything with long strap and top handle is good. Okay. And this version still have the Y stitching on top of the bag. Yeah. So it's not the very, very current model. It's the model right before that, and I do find that this model's the structure is much better than the current one, which is more slouchy. I think this one holds the shape much better, and in terms of maintaining and upholding the shape, I think that this model is much better. I bought this, I'm not too sure, 5 years? No, three, 3-4 years. Yeah, and the structure is still very good. I use this mainly, mostly for my work. Okay, next. This is a Christmas gift from my brother-in-law or my sister. This is a Ralph Lauren. I'm not sure of the name of this model. It looks like this. It's a huge bag. It served me pretty well for about 2 years. I use it for my work to hold my laptop. It holds great, but the problem with it is it's so heavy. So right now I don't use this bag at all. In fact, I've already put it up for sale. Okay, next. So sorry about the rubber bands. Please just look past that. Is my Chanel Jumbo Black Caviar Leather in gold hardware. This is the single flap. Good bag. Very chic. I just sometimes think that maybe I should switch to a silver hardware. But I still really, really like the gold hardware look, so now it's still in my collection, probably will be forever. Next! Oh, it's already 11 minutes, I gotta go faster. This is also a Chanel in petite shopper tote PST in gold hardware and caviar leather. This is currently also on sale. This is a very good bag to have. The only problem with it is it doesn't go with my lifestyle in a way that I'm a very petite person, and this actually look a little bit boxy on me because I'm so flat and small. And I do find that the strap keep falling off my narrow shoulder, so it really is not the issue with the bag itself. It's mainly myself. As you can see, the structure is very well maintained. I would say that this almost look brand new. Next, this is another of my favorite bags. I like bucket bag in general. So this is the best bucket bag I have from Louis Vuitton LV, monogram. This is a very old version, or it's probably a vintage right now. It's an old version of Petite Noé. So it has the vacata leather or fachetta leather or the raw leather right below here. As you can see, mine is super smooth and clean, honey colored. Love it. Holds a ton and is pretty much in a very great shape. The raw leather has patinaed very, very well, and this thing can, and there's a shoulder strap in the raw leather as well, and it's very, very comfortable after so many years of used. Good bag. Next. This is my Proenza Schooler. I think it's a medium size. I cannot remember. A purple color. Yeah, I find that this bag I don't use as much. It's in gold hardware or antique gold hardware. I'm not sure why. I live in a very humid and rainy country, so sometimes I do think about the weather before I bring my bags out, and this bag stressed me out. So I don't really carry unless it's a sunny weather. Yep, very nice too. It looks very, it gives a very young school college look, I would say. Okay. Next we have the Hermes. And this is the Evelyn, and this is a Clermont leather with the perforated H here. I do think that this H in front is very flashy. So anyway, this is supposed to be the back of the bag, and this is supposed to be the front. But I think nobody will put this in front. Really? But the functionality will prove it to be a front bag. This is a very comfortable bag because it comes with a canvas shoulder strap, so it's very comfortable on the shoulder. Great bag to have if you are just going for a casual day out. Highly recommended too. Let me just flip it. I just like it, the back side. It just look much better. See that the leather is very, very rich and supple. Always the case with MS. Love it. Next, this is a bag that I bought from the United States about two or three years ago. I believe it's 2 years ago, and I never used it. Right now, I have already listed it up. So for sale too. This is a light gold foil finish here, and it does come with a long chain strap with a leather strap in the middle. Very easy bag to use, but because as you can see, I've got so many bags and this is a light color bag, I just get I'm just not too sure. This is not up my alley right now. Next, this is from Louis Vuitton. It's also the same bucket bag, same size, PM size, but this is not the monogram one. This is the Epi leather in black, noir, and gold hardware. I think this is a vintage too, because right now the hardware has all turned silver, if I'm not wrong. I'm not too sure, don't quote me on that. Yes, my lining inside has torn, and I've sewn it up myself. Very badly done. I can get Elfie to do it for me, but right now I don't think it's... I'm not too fussy about the interior, really. And overall, this is the bag that I carry when it's rainy season too. So, love this bag too. Epi leather is good. Next, this is my Celine and my only Celine bag right now. And this is the micro size. This is in the blue color. I'm not too sure of the name of the blue. Maybe it's ink, I-N-K, ink blue. Or midnight blue. I'm not too sure. And this is the gold hardware. Spacious bag to have. Good size, even for a petite girl like me. Petite and short girl like me. Very spacious and easy to carry. The handle is very comfortable. But I do not recommend to put a lot of things inside this bag. Yes, it gets heavy pretty easily. Well, luckily, I don't really carry a lot. Next, this is my Hermès, a relatively low profile model from Hermès. This is the Garden Party. I believe this is a TPM size 30. And this is in brown color. And I'm not sure, I cannot remember, but I think this is... It should be the Swift leather. Very, very soft. I like this bag too. Very comfortable when you carry it. And the strap is very comfortable and soft. Yeah. Currently, I wrap this up with a regular... This is not from Hermès. Twilly. And the interior is very nice with the Hermès orange color. I've got a stain here. Ugh, I have no idea how to remove that myself. If anyone knows, please let me know. And the interior, I believe this is silk. With the bow, you see, I'm not sure how to pronounce that word, BOLDUC pattern inside, so it's very nice when you carry it. It's very MS, but it's basically quite low profile, so you really can't see the brand from outside, but when you look inside, you definitely can tell from the color. Very nice bag too. Next, this is also a Garden Party by Hermès. Everything same as that bag. It's just that the leather is different. I believe this is the Negonda leather. Black color, noir. With the silver hardware. Okay, this is a... I love this as well as that. This is newer. A younger bag. And that is much older. But this bag is delicious. Very comfortable. I love this too. Okay, next. This is the, I don't think this need introduction. You see this everywhere. This is the Louis Vuitton LV Neverfull bag. Damier Ibin in the MM size. I bought this pretty recently. It's an exchange with my friend. I bought a new one and I have no use for the pouch inside, and my friend need that pouch, so we basically did an exchange and she charged me lower, and I do feel that the condition is very, very well kept, almost to brand new, I feel myself. But the fact that everyone is nuts over this bag, I don't feel that it suit me very much. I do agree that this holds a lot, but like I said previously, I'm not a person who carries a lot. Maybe once in a while, and mostly the case is accidental. Maybe when I'm shopping and the shopping get a little bit out of control. Other than that, yeah, I find that the bag is too spacious for my use. Yeah, and it do look a little bit bulky on my body frame. I'm still thinking, should I just keep it? You know, tastes and lifestyle change. Maybe I should just keep it and we'll see what happens. Oh, this is also a rainy season bag for me. Great bag. But I'm not too sure. And this is another of my Louis Vuitton mono... I'm sorry of my fingers. So sorry. This is my Louis Vuitton LV backpack. This is called... This is a vintage bag already. I had it for the longest time. This is from a relative of mine. Yeah. And she gave it to me when I was still in my school time. So it worked great during those school times. But right now, I haven't finished the introduction. I think this is called the Montesoros. I'm not sure how that pronounced, but this is the biggest version, GM size. So you can tell that this is a GM size when you see the golden metal rod here. Very nice rod whereby you can carry just like that, very chic. And it comes with the canvas back strap, which is very comfortable on the shoulder. And it feels a ton also. And for easy access, there's also a small pocket here, zippered up. Yeah, very nice. It looks very nice on the video. But in fact, the leather has a little bit dried up. I need to condition this, but I'm not too sure how to condition a raw leather, frankly. And I'm too afraid to do that myself. Oh, that's the date code, and this is the 1997 bag. Okay, next we have... So sorry, my mom just barged in, so I have to pause the video. Well, okay, next we are coming to the end already. Whew, my long shum. This is a medium-sized black against the brown leather. Quite a classic gold hardware. And this is the pilage, the nylon version. I had it half old like this. And the next long shum is this one. This is a gunmetal black. I use it mainly for my... when I go overseas as an additional carry-on. Very accessible and easy to use. And next, this is the leather version. I'm not too sure of the size here. It's silver hardware. Yeah, the leather version and brown color. It's probably a large size. And that's it. The full collection. So now I have to be the bird. Okay, as you can see, my queen size bed has barely space to hold all of my bags, and they are all in very close distance from each other. So I do think that this is too excessive, but I really do love all of these bags. But I think I really need to downsize. Maybe if you guys can help me out as to which bag I should keep and sell, do let me know. And if you are interested in any of my bag, maybe you can just leave a message down in the comment section. Then I'll try to contact you and give you my private mail, and we can talk about that. Yeah. It is very excessive. In total, there's 28 bags I just count. And this is excluding the SLG and the clutches I have. And if you guys need any further detailed review of any of the bags, do let me know as soon as possible. I'll just make sure that, you know, I do a thorough review before I sell the bag off. Yeah. So I hope this is my first video, and I hope to get the support from you guys. If you guys love this kind of video, please like and subscribe to me. Yeah, so then that's it. I'll come back shortly after this video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.